Hello, Sophie here. So while I've been working on a new 3D painting in grease pencil, I kind of accidentally stumbled on a way to get a gradient brush, and it's a really cool effect. So this trick requires a tablet and a stylus, because we will be using pen pressure today, but you definitely don't need anything fancy. Also, I thought it would be fun to open up the properties window for my Wacom tablet and just have it over to the side here so we can see how hard I'm pressing throughout this video. It also made me realize that I've been pressing way harder than I needed to, and RIP to my poor expensive tablet. So I've just opened up a new 2D animation workspace, and I'll click on the brush icon over here and select the pen brush. This trick will work with absolutely any brush. And then up here, I'll click this icon to make sure we're in vertex paint mode. Then we want to open up the stroke dropdown up here, check the box that says randomize, bring our hue value up to 1, and click on both boxes next to it. And I've gotten the best results by giving my strokes a simplify value of around 0.1. And then, we have magic. So, what is this sorcery exactly? Let's start again with the pencil brush. By putting the hue randomization to 1, this means that the stroke could have any color. If we were to put it to 0.5, and then we chose this blue color at the top of the color wheel, imagine that the stroke could go halfway across the color wheel in either direction. So it could be anything from this yellow-green to this purple. With neither of these two boxes selected, Blender will just assign a random hue within the range you set to every vertex. The first box makes it so that the stroke as a whole and not every individual vertex is assigned that random color. And it's with the last box that things get interesting. This makes so that the random hue that Blender wants to give the stroke will only be applied when we use full pen pressure. When we press softly, we get the hue we chose. And when we press hard, we get that random color. And when we vary our pen pressure, we get a gradient. And then the simplify value we give just helps to make the colors flow seamlessly into one another. Without it, we get these kinds of striations, these lines, and it's an interesting look, just not one I'm after. Now I know what you're thinking, this is too good to be true. And I have to mention that there is a downside. Because the gradient comes from a randomly assigned color, we have no control over it. I can control the color I use, of course, and how far away the other color will be, but I can't control what the second color will be. But I wouldn't be making this video if I didn't think there was some awesome potential here. We could create a watercolor calligraphy brush. You know those calligraphy videos where the ink changes colors. I can't be the only one who spent hours entranced by them in my life. Well, now we can make our own. So I'm going to use the pencil brush. I'll give it a large radius that is affected by pen pressure. And I'll put the strength at 1, but have it not be affected by pen pressure. And then I put the hue randomization anywhere from 0.5 to 0.75, and a simplify value of 0.05. Then when you make your calligraphy, which will tend to involve some different line thicknesses, the parts of the letters for which you press harder will be both bigger and more colorful. But the parts that are thin, for which you press lightly, will be the same color. This helps to unify your piece. It gives it a central color that every other color relates back to. This lets you have a multicolored effect without it feeling too chaotic, and that unifying color is important. Before, I would just have the hue randomization affect the stroke, and so you'd get this. In order to keep it from being too chaotic, I would need to keep the hue randomization value quite small. But with pen pressure, now I can give it a large value, and if I use this for line art, the strokes will still all feel related to one another, but you can get these pops of color that really wow. And then I can also press harder for areas that I intentionally want to make more different than the rest. And then, how I've actually been using it in this piece is I give the gradient to the pencil brush without changing any other settings. And then I use this to color in areas with soft hatching. Because I mostly press softly, the colors stay quite similar. But then every once in a while, I can press hard to get these little bursts of color. So for this week's video, I really wanted to give a shout out to Maylee. She's an illustrator and 3D artist from France who's been doing amazing things with grease pencil and geometry nodes. Like, she makes me want to learn geometry nodes. It looks so cool. She's been making all sorts of really cool scenes and streaming a lot of it on Twitch. So I will link her social medias in the description box below. So that's the trick that I've discovered. I hope this was helpful. If you make anything inspired by this or any of my videos, I would love to see it. You can tag me on Instagram and on Twitter. I am at Sophie Jantak everywhere. Thank you so much for being here. Talk soon. Bye.